In this video, I will explain what is log management. That means, what is the significance of log management? To ensure data consistency within an SAP system, we must ensure that data records cannot be accessed and changed by more than one user at any one time. To do this, SAP system has its own log management concept. From a database perspective, every dialog step forms a physical and logical unit, the database transaction. The database log administration can only coordinate this type of database transaction. From an SAP point of view, however, this is not sufficient because SAP transactions, which are formed from a sequence of logically related work steps that are consistent in business terms, are generally made up of several dialog steps. SAP systems need to have their own log management. This is implemented using the NQ work process. This also ensures that the platform independence of the log management is maintained. The SAP log concept works on the principle that SAP programs make log entries for data records to be processed in a log table. Log entries can only be made if none already exist for the table entries to be logged. The NQ work process manages the log of the SAP transactions in the log table. The log table is located in the main memory of the instance with the NQ work process. The instance whose main memory contains the log table is also known as the NQ server. So look at this graphic. User Smith tries to change the data within the database. Above dispatcher, dialog work process and change access. So once the change access is permitted, Smith has its own lock. Okay, if the mayor tries to change the same data, he will have only read access. He is not allowed to change anything in the database. That means that particular record cannot be changed by the mayor until Smith has lock in the lock table. If a user wants change access to data, the executing dialog work process requests a lock. To do so, the application developer must program this request explicitly. If a dialog request is processed on the NQ server, the dialog work process can access the lock table directly. It now checks whether a new lock can be generated. That is, whether there is a collision with locks that have already been set. If a lock can be set, the dialog work process creates it and the user, that is lock owner, is given the lock key. The lock key is kept in the user context in the shared memory. If the dialog work process that processes the user request and the NQ work process are not running on the same instance, these two work processes communicate through the message server. In this case, the lock request is forwarded from the dialog work process to the NQ work process via the dispatches and the message server. The NQ work process now checks whether a lock can be set. If this is possible, the lock is set by the NQ work process and the lock key transferred to the requesting dialog work process via dispatcher and message server. When the lock is requested, the system checks whether the requested lock conflicts with existing entries in the lock table. If the lock table already contains corresponding entries, the lock request is refused. The application program can then inform the user that the requested operation cannot currently be executed. The application developer can choose between different lock modes. These are all the different lock modes are available. The application developer can choose between different lock modes while programming. Those are write logs, read logs, enhanced write logs, optimistic logs. Let us look at what are all these log modes. Logs. Log mode exclusive. The log data can be edited only by the one user. The request for another write log and another read log are rejected. A write log protects the locked objects against all types of other transactions. Only the same lock owner can set the lock again. That is cumulative. Read logs. Lock mode shared. Several users can have read access to the locked data at the same time. The requests for additional read logs are accepted even if they are from other users. A write log is rejected. Write log is rejected here. Enhanced write logs. Lock mode exclusive, non-cumulative. Enhanced write logs. Lock mode exclusive, non-cumulative. While write logs can be successively requested and released by the same transaction, an enhanced write log can only be requested once, even by the same transaction. All other requests for logs are rejected. Optimistic lock. Lock mode optimistic. Optimistic logs respond like read log at first and can be changed to write logs. An optimistic lock is set if the user displays the data in change mode. Optimistic locks on the same object do not collide. If the user wants to save the data, the optimistic lock must be changed to a write lock. This fails if someone set a non-optimistic lock on the object before. Other optimistic locks on the object are deleted in the process. Locks set by an application program are either released by the application program itself or by the update program once the database has been changed. Logs that have been passed on to an update work process in this way are also written to a file at operating system level and can therefore be restored if the NQ server goes down. Transaction SM12. It can be opened using Tools, Administration, Monitor, Log Entries menu item from the SAP Easy Access screen. Displays the locks that are currently set. If a lock has already been inherited to the update process, the backup flag has also been set. Such a lock will also be included in the lock table again after restarting the NQ server. There are basically two ways of deleting locks held by users. Ending the user session in the user overview. There is a transaction called SM04 which can be opened either using SM04 or Tools Administration Monitor SAP System Monitoring User Overview from SAP Easy Access screen. Or also it can be deleted using manually deleting the lock entries in SM12. You can use SM12 to delete the lock entry from the lock table. The first method, ending the user session, also results in the original lock owner leaving the transaction and thereby releasing all locks held. The second method, manually deleting using SM12, merely deletes the lock entry from the lock table. This theoretically enables several users to change the same data record simultaneously. Before deleting locks, the system administrator must first check using transaction SM04 whether the user who wants the lock is still logged on to the system. You should only delete lock entries with transaction SM12 if the lock owner is no longer logged on to the system but still wants the lock. For example, if the connection between SAP GUI and SAP system has been broken because the user has switched off his or her front-end computer without logging off from the system. Okay. Now this is about theoretical explanation. Let us go to system and to look at this particular experiment. Let us try to change something within the SAP system.
Okay, this is SAP Easy Access screen. From here, you can look at the user information by clicking on this arrow mark. The user logged on to the system is Salman. Okay, let us look at Salman's own data using SU3T code. SU3T code. Or also you can get this information from system, user profile, own data. So both functionality same. Either you can use SU3 or system, user profile, own data. Just SU3, just hit enter. So from here, Salman can change his own data using these fields available in the screen. So during he is editing his own data, if the administrator tries to change something about this particular user, so let us see what is the warning message we will get on the screen. Just I am opening another session by clicking on here. This is the button for creating new session. So this is the new session available. From here, just I am using SU01, that is user maintenance T code, for administering Salman user account. So just enter the Salman user account here. Input the Salman and try to click on the change button from the application toolbar. So you should be displayed with this particular message. Maintenance of user Salman locked by user Salman. So user, the Salman user himself locked that particular user for changing something about his own data in the database. So now let us look at the lock table. Lock table can be viewed using SM12. So using SM12 you can read the log table. It will show all the logs available in the system at the moment. So this is the log. So one log entry is there in the log table, that is within the client 001, who is locked it, username is this, and what is the time, and log mode is E. And USR 04 table, and so this is, with this information you can find out who is locked. Okay, so now we have a option to end this particular lock by selecting this and clicking on the delete button, so that remaining users can access the same data to change. Or also you can open another session to end the user session using SM04T code. So this is another session. From here, SM04, hit SM04. Okay, this is the user logged in to the system, Salman user. So from here you can double click here and you can end the session, so that the lock entry from the lock table will be released. Like this, maintain user's own data, display and delete locks user list. So this can be deleted and this can be deleted. Maintain user's own data, this session I am going to delete. Just continue. So end session, you can click on the end session, so that particular session will be ended. That is, maintain user's profile, that is own data, will be ended. Click on end session. So if I click on end session, that is gone. So nothing, that is, that particular changing his own data is gone. That session is not there at all. That session is closed. Now if you click on refresh button here, that should, the entry should go from the lock table. So in this way it is gone. Now if administrator tries to change the data of that particular user, it should allow. Like for suppose if I go back and type SU01 and enter Salman, right click on the change button from the application toolbar, so that it should allow me to change the data of this particular user account. So this is the concept of lock mechanism within the SAP system. And so with this type of mechanism, no duplicate data can be saved in the database. I hope you understood very well, both theory and practical. So if you listen this video again and again, you will get full clarity about the subject and practice these experiments using SM04, SM12 and SU01 T codes. Okay, so thanks for watching.